Hello, and welcome back to my channel, Men with Mare. All right, you all, I'm gonna do one of my absolute favorites from Taylor, and that is the one. A friend of mine, Melanie Little, who is an attorney, who has a YouTube channel, you should check her out. She sent me this video of the Counting Crows singing the one. We do something, don't you think so? You know they fallen with your chosen family, and it would have been sweet if it could have been me. In my defense, I have none for digging up the grave another time, but it would have been fun if you would have been the one. And I was like, I've got to do it. So without further ado, let's do it. Thank you to all of the people that bought the book. It means so much to me. I know that the books have been delayed a little bit with shipping, so a lot of people haven't gotten theirs, but please let me know your thoughts on it. I'm happy to hear them all.
Some new shit. Been saying yes instead of no. I thought I saw you at the bus stop. I didn't though. I hit the ground running each night. I hit the Sunday matinee. You know the greatest films of all time were never made. I guess you never know, never know. Wanted me, you really should have showed. And if you never bleed, you're never gonna grow. And it's all right now.
So I think that she's saying to this person, look, if you never put yourself out there, if you never bleed, then you're never gonna grow. But it's all in it right now, you know? Didn't work out. I don't know. There's something really beautiful about this song. I like where she's saying, like, it's essentially like I'm doing really well, but
I think of you.
But we were something, don't you think so? Roaring twenties, tossing pennies in the pool. And if my wishes came true, it would have been you. In my defense, I have none for never leaving well enough alone. But it would have been fun if you would have been the one.
Okay, so if you've ever listened to my analysis of happiness, you'll know that I do believe that Taylor bases a lot of her writing off of the book, The Great Gatsby, or themes around that. So talking about the Roaring Twenties, it could be like your actual 20s, not the era, like 1920s, where, you know, you're kind of wild and you're tossing pennies in the pool. So you're making wishes on things and trying things out, people out, stuff like that. I think she's just saying, like, it could have kept going on and it could have been really fun if it was you, you know, like the one that got away.
Ooh, I have this dream you're doing cool shit, having adventures on your own. You meet some woman on the internet and take her home. We never painted by the numbers, baby, but we were making it count. You know the greatest loves of all time are over now.
So I think that she's saying some of the greatest loves of all time are over now. Some of the greatest films were never made. So it was premature, I think, the ending to their love. And I think that talking about you'll meet somebody on the internet and take her home, it's kind of like you're choosing to spend your time with someone that doesn't actually know you, that someone that doesn't have a very, very deep connection. It could be someone with a fear of commitment. It could be someone who needs something new, who craves, you know, dating and that newness.
I guess you never know, never know. And it's another day waking up alone. But we were something, don't you think so? Roaring twenties, tossing pennies in the pool. And if my wishes came true, it would have been you. In my
my defense, I have none. But never leaving well enough alone. But it would have been fun if you would have been the one. Persist and resist the temptation to ask you if one thing had been different. Would everything be different today? We were something, don't you think so? Rosé flowing with your chosen family. And it would have been sweet if it could have been me. In my defense, I have none. Digging up the grave another time. But it would have been fun if you would have been the one.
So underrated. It's so, so good. I wonder why, you know, she wasn't chosen. Talking about rosé flowing with your chosen family, talking about maybe that person married or would be expected to marry someone of a certain stature. Kind of makes me think of champagne problems, like somebody that was rich like them, or someone, you know, the Great Gatsby, like, you know, a lot of times, like someone that maybe matches them. And instead of just being like, whatever, I want to do what I want and I'm going to choose you. They chose maybe not to upset their own parents, but instead are looking for love in all these wrong places. That's just a story I've made up in my head. I have no idea. I don't think that that's what it's totally about. But I think it's a really, really beautiful, simple song, but makes me really nostalgic. Think about like past loves and what could have been. And it's beautiful. All right. I hope you all enjoyed this. Take care.